I just want you to know that you mean a lot to me, and if the need arose, I would kill for you.
Yeah, no offense. I've watched you garrote someone over a grape. That doesn't mean much coming from you.
I'd die for you?
I've read your diary. That also doesn't mean much. Also, you should probably see a therapist.
I'd let go of a long-standing grudge for you.
Aww.
And remember, kids, the next time that somebody tells you, the government wouldn't do that, oh yes they would.
God gives the hardest battles to his strongest soldiers. When did I sign up for the war? When did I enlist?
Okay, why'd you run away?
Can we not talk about that?
I am not.
I woke up in a noble.
Well.
That's a weird fucking tone, man.
That's just the way he sounds. He has an asshole voice. Joe, tell him he's okay.
Everything is great.
Dude.
It's really cute that you're gonna defeat me with the power of friendship and all, but again, I am the devil from the Bible, so I don't know how
you
well
motherfucker,
work.
You didn't let me finish.
Go ahead.
I have all this power in my hands.
Shut up, the fuck up. I don't care. I do not care.
How long have you been standing there?
Don't try that. You know the concept of time confuses me.
That's right, everybody. It's your favorite boy.
Get the fuck out or I'll...
You can't handle the uber instincts of my uber autism. Observe.
Sending those creatures after her instead of myself was mercy. And in spite of your hypocrisies and insults, I have begged you to safely get out of my way. You have exhausted my patience. But I do hope you understand that even now, what's about to happen? This is me being reasonable.
Can you believe it, guys? Christmas, just a week away. Christmas is in a week. Woohoo! I am so happy about this information.
Swarm of bears?
Yeah.
Herd of bears?
Yeah, I've heard of bears, but...
Oh, God.
You looked so...
Different? Yeah. Well, my hair was buzzed, and I didn't have these sweet old tatties yet.
You played guitar, right?
Uh-huh. Still do. Still live. You should come see us.
Okay, this is the story of how me and my friends got called Satan worshippers / devil worshippers by some dude at a church yesterday. I want to preface that I was dressed as Negro DiAngelo. This shirt, ripped jeans, lots of little rainbows on my costume, and obviously the skulls and the skull rings and necklace. And my other friend was dressed as Bianca, my other friend was dressed as Frank. Frank had the saber-tooth spear, and my friend had a small knife that was sticking out of their backpack, and both of which looked very, very fake. I need to preface it with that. So we're taking photos, at the side of the judge. We're near the gift shop, but literally no one was walking in and out. The place was pretty much deserted, even though it was the Sunday. Pretty much everyone was just inside the cathedral. We had a Nikon camera that had an interchangeable lens. And usually in situations like this, the security or just people who own the place in public spaces don't want you profiting from photos that you take on their property. So I presumed it was something about that at first, but it wasn't. So this guy comes over, he's wearing a suit and tie, and he's staying like this and goes, excuse me, do you mind if I ask what the purpose is of the photos that you are taking here? I say, it's not for commercial use. This is recreational. We're not profiting from any of these photos. He goes, oh, well, that's very interesting. It just seems like you have a lot of daggers and teeth here with you. We say, no, all of that is very fake. They're all fake props and are not at all harmful. My friend then goes over to pick up their fake dagger to show the guy, I presume he's security, but I don't even know, he didn't look like security. Tried to show him that the knife was very, very fake, and he did this. He went like this. He went, whoa, I think I've seen enough. Please don't bring that near me. All right, it's time you get off the premises. You know, these are not, this is not my policy. This is just how things are. You don't look like tourists, so we can't have you here. At this point, I know it's bullshit. Okay, I just walk off. I'm kind of angry. I don't want to talk to him anymore. Now, this is where it gets interesting. There were these other cosplayers who were taking photos nearby. They had swords, and we told them, we just got kicked off the church premises, for having unsafe objects. Just letting you know, in case you want to hide your swords. They were like, all good. Then 30 minutes later, they come and fight us again. I'm going to paraphrase this bit because I was tired at the time and had trouble with my hearing. They were like, oh yeah, no, he was fine with us. He actually told us that there might be some like unsafe people with daggers who were Satan worshippers nearby. So we just needed to be careful. I lost my shit. This is both the strangest and funniest thing that has ever happened to me on a shoot in my life. I swear. This is Australia. This is not America. You don't have religious fanatics, like, around every corner. I was just kind of amazed that people like this exist. I'm just surprised that this guy did not have, like, an ounce of self-awareness. I'm amazed.
I need to feel something. Harry, can you tell me something that'll piss me off?
Boba Fett's better than Mondo.
Yep, that'll do it.
Live people ignore the strange and unusual. I myself am strange and unusual.
So if Derek was a sophomore back then, how old was he? How old were you? How old are you now?
Not as young as we could have been, but not as old as you might think.
Okay, that was frustratingly vague. How old are you?
I'm 17.
See, that's an answer. That's how we answer people.
Well, 17, how you'd measure in years.
All right, I'm just gonna drop it.
You tricked me.
Tricked you? No, I saved you.
Long story short, this is my grave.
Want me to make you one too?
This is really bumming me out.
The power of Christ compels you.
Does it, Jay?
The power of Christ compels you.
Is the power of Christ compelling me? Is that what's happening?
The power of Christ compels you.
Guess what? It's not that compelling.
I don't know. Everything here is edible.
What's wrong with your lip?
Good. Towards Aaron.
Why do you keep tapping your lip?
Kiss me.
Breaking news, a local family is forced out of their home by ghosts.
Who are they gonna call?
Ghostbusters?
No, their insurance company. That's just stupid what you said.
Just realized I've yet to use this filter, and you know, I've gotta, you know. We all know the answer, but is it gonna get it right? Hey, I mean, I'll take it.
Well, as a straight man, my IG's all pictured of myself.
What did you just call me?
As a straight man.
Oh, mm-hmm. So now we're just saying things. Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay f- calm!
Wait.
I've always known I would marry Rich. Why should I be ashamed of that?
It's nothing to be ashamed of, as long as you love him.
Well, I believe we have some power over who we love. It isn't something that just happens to a person.
I think the poets might disagree.
Well, I'm not a poet. I'm just a woman. And as a woman, there's no way for me to make my own money. Not enough to earn a living or to support my family. And if I had my own money, which I don't, that money would belong to my husband the moment we got married. And if we had children, they would be his, not mine. They would be his property. So don't sit there and tell me that marriage isn't an economic proposition, because it is. It may not be for you, but it most certainly is for me.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning, now I'm entering my bed. Had a few dreams about you, I can't tell you what we did.
You think healing is hard, huh? Try healing something. That is hard. That requires patience. You can break something in 2 seconds, but it can take forever to fix it.
I know that you have great taste, Adrian.
My name is Luca.
Can I help you?
I like chocolate milk.
Yes, I caught that before.
Can I have some chocolate milk?
What do I look like, your mother?
And you have to treat a car like you treat a woman.
Go on.
No. I sense I've made a mistake of some kind.
Fresh lemonade, freshly squeezed.
Billy.
Her eating her pie.
Billy, stop.
he's always like, Ivan, how'd you bag a baddie? How'd you bag that baddie, bro? I didn't bag shit. Adriana picked me up from my neck and threw me over her shoulder, and I've been on it ever since. And I ain't got no plans of getting off anytime soon.
I just want to say, I'm part of the LGBTQ community. And this is my best friend, Valentina. She's an ally. Talk, Valentina.
Ally.
Bestie vibes only, 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 vibes the best, bestie vibes only.
Look, when I made this video, I expected people to agree with me about Nico not being a Slytherin. However, what I did not expect was people to have big arguments about Nico having to be a Hufflepuff and cannot be anything else. And also some funny arguments about Percy, but if you want my opinions on Percy, just like ask me in the comments or something. It needs its own video. So I've come to restate my opinion like I do every couple of months because the video will get deleted or muted or I'll take it down or whatever. Nico is a Gryffindor and possibly a Ravenclaw because he has multiple Ravenclaw traits, especially present before he presented as a demigod. However, he leans more into the Gryffindor these days. Anyway. So, the number one thing that people get wrong when they try to sort Nico into a house is they base their opinions of him and the way that he acted on just the first series and the decisions he made during that. Because in the first series, he was traumatized and mentally unstable. Now tell me, because I know a lot of you are probably mentally unstable beings. When you're mentally unstable, how rational are the thoughts that you're making? When you're reacting to trauma, how rational and clear are those thoughts that you're making? Because they're not. So basing what we believe about Nico's personality based on the first series it's incorrect and it's not him thinking freely and consciously. So it makes no sense to base it off that. Now we see Nico start to make conscious decisions at the very end of the first series with convincing his dad to battle in the Battle of Manhattan and coming in at the last second. That was very much a, I don't care about loyalty, I don't care about my grudges, I'm gonna do what I believe is right. And so we brought his dad to the battle. Now, we see in the second series, we see more of him making these decisions with him going down to the doors of death voluntarily because he knew, well, first off, no one was gonna miss him, which was Jesus Christ King, what the fuck? Number two, he knew that he was one of the only people who would be able to do it because he was able to see things correctly, but also worse, so double trauma. And number three, he just knew it was the right thing to do and he didn't want anyone else getting hurt. So it was very much a self-sacrifice moment. So that's very Gryffindor, like textbook Gryffindor right there. But one of the primary things I want to bring up that I've not brought up before, and it is more recent and more solid, is Nico, in the last book of the Trials of Apollo series, Tower of Nero, going, instead of being loyal, as if he were a Hufflepuff, and staying with Will and staying at the camp, saying, no, I need to go down and help Bob because I know it's the right thing to do. And also being very self-sacrificial in that aspect. So that is why I think he is very much a textbook Gryffindor. His Gryffindor traits way outweigh any of the Hufflepuff traits that people bring up, and I'm sick of it. Anyway.
Do I even weigh anything to you?
No. It's like holding a couple of grapes.
Hope everybody's having a great Pride Month! Shout out to the gays!
No one's the boss of me, Tennyson. Remember that.
Please lighten up, Kevin.
Okay, Gwen.
So what do we do?
There's only one thing to do. We have to induce amnesia.
I just want to say, I'm part of the LGBTQ community, and this is my best friend, Valentina. She's an ally. Talk, Valentina.
Ally.
wouldn't wish that upon my worst enemy, unless, of course, we're talking about my enemy, Gwyneth Paltrow. Fuck you, Gwyneth Paltrow. You know what you did.
Christian. Rehab. Christian had to go to rehab because he couldn't drink beer like a normal person.
Sir, will you please stop staring at me?
Where's the rest of you?
Dude, this does not serve you anymore. Why are you hanging on to it?
It was a gift from my mother. And you don't just throw away a gift.
You take things really sensitively, and that's fine.
No,
I just need to not make those jokes with you. No, I don't think I think they're just, like, rude. But to me, it's a joke. To you, it's rude. So I won't make them to you, because you don't take it the way that I'm meaning it, which is as a joke.
You two can manage not to kill each other while I'm gone.
Oh, please. We're not children.
He shouldn't die.
Yes, fuck you.
Are you... At this time, you are sleeping. It's not possible. No. Get up from the bed. I don't want...
Jackson.
Sorry, Coach, I haven't seen him since the last time I saw him.
When was that?
Last time I saw him? It's definitely the time I saw him last.
I see you, you're walking across the campus, cool professor studying romances.
Dear Shakespeare, could you write a happy ending, please? Could you write a happy ending? We just deserve a happy ending, please. Please.
Every kid with autism know that my heart with
them. Damn, look, they got girl skateboards.
Oh my god.
You can skate now.
They got gay skateboards.
Oh my god.
You can skate.
We're fucking set.
Always shoot your shot. If you want to date someone, ask them out. Make a move. Unless the person you want to date is me. Leave me alone.
Freddy! You're supposed to be on lockdown.
Vanessa.
You look really pretty.
Therefore I have value?
No. No, that's not what I meant at all. I was just...
I'm messing with you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You look pretty too.
When you first met me, that girl wasn't me. She had my same blue eyes and my stupid big teeth. Oh, I know you miss the sad girl I was before, but I don't know who that is anymore.
I needed a soldier. You wanted a father.
Well, I guess we're both disappointed.
Listen, there are not many opinions I hold that I'm very passionate about. However, Nico being a Gryffindor is one of the three opinions that I hold that I will fight people to the death about. So I'm making a video on this.
Just a bit of forewarning. I'm not angry. I'm just very passionate. So if I come off as angry in this video, I'm not. If you'd put him in Slytherin, then I would actually be angry. But you didn't. So let's explain why Nico is a Gryffindor. When we sort characters into Hogwarts houses, we need to think about their morals first and then how they act towards others second. And in order to fully explain why Nico is a Gryffindor, we're going to start at the start. So with Nico, straight after Bianca's death, a lot of the things he does are fueled by his grudges. And because they're fueled by grudges, a lot of people misconstrue that, and especially because we see everything through Percy's point of view, a lot of people believe that that is done through loyalty. His grudges and holding them are not loyalty. Him bringing Percy to Hades was done out of selfishness, frankly, because he was still building himself as a person. He was 12, almost, for God's sake. So I don't blame him for that. However, it at the end of that book is really when we mark when he decided to stop being driven by his grudges and start working towards the things that he believed is right. But even before he decides that he's going to do the right thing, subconsciously we see him bringing Percy to Hades because he did believe it was the right thing, dipping Percy in the River Styx because he thought it was the most beneficial thing for Percy, coming to the Battle of Manhattan because he wanted to prove to everyone around him at camp and also to Percy that he was a good, trustworthy person. Everything he does throughout the second series is fueled by him wanting to prove himself past the big motif of Hades Kid Bad. I think the biggest example of that is him literally going down to Tartarus to close the doors of death himself because he believed he was the only person who could do it in the right way and he didn't want to endanger anyone else. And when it didn't work and he was technically defeated, he held so much hero's guilt over that. Not to mention a lot of the reasons he ends up in certain situations is because of his extreme lack of self-preservation, which is very Gryffindor, by the way, and it's his extreme stubbornness, another Gryffindor trait. Without his Gryffindor traits, I doubt half the things that happened in the second series would have happened. I don't think the Athena statue would have ended up back at camp if he hadn't been determined enough to get it there. I understand people seeing Nico as a Hufflepuff, however, his Gryffindor traits outweigh the Hufflepuff traits 10 to 1.
This is not cutlery. This is not cutlery.
I'm not gonna just sit and have dinner with you. I tried to kill me and then just broke into my house.
I did not try to kill you. A, I put you on a wire to remove an obstacle. And B, I did not break anything. I am way too talented than that. And C, stop being so defensive.
Being gay isn't your choice. It's mine. You're gay now.
Saw a photo, you look joyous. My eyes are green, I need my veggies.
Luckily, most of us have that little voice inside our head that says, Turning the car into oncoming traffic is counterproductive!
Oh my god, he's dead? No!
Close your eyes, that's where you'll find me.
do you understand?
7 foot frame, right so long as bad. When he calls your name, it all fades to black. Yeah, he sees your dreams.
Tell me what to do to make it all feel better. Maybe it's a cruel joke on me. Whatever, whatever. Trust means there's way more pain for me. Forever.
Fucker! Ah, Carl, Jesus Christ! What the hell are you doing telling people that we're a gay couple? Oh, heard that through the grapevine, did you?
I dreamed about you while I was in my poison coma. I was all old and withered, and you were still nice and pink.
You think I'm nice?
You're not supposed to be bothering me on my holiday time, Valentina.
Oh, bothering you? Oh, no. I'm just here paying my respects.
Mm. You know, coming here makes you look desperate.
Hey, why aren't koalas considered bears?
Because they're marsupials.
Because they're marsupials.
No, it's because they don't have the right qualifications.
I thought maybe you could love me like you used to. Even though I'm different.
How old are you?
I have no idea.
110.
What?
You said how I got your address? Don't even worry about that.
I like your ears.
Mine?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. I like your spots.
Really? I used to cover them up, but, you know.
Every time I feel good, I think it'll last forever. But it doesn't.
How does it feel to live my dream?
For me, buy a big diamond ring for me. Would you get down on your knees for me? Pop that pretty question right now, baby.
On the bright side, we might have inflicted the optimal amount of trauma onto this child for it to become funny.
Oh, yeah, you can become a Minecraft YouTuber.
Yeah!
Listen, I can't give any more information, but I fear I may have girl-bossed a bit too close to the sun.
Only thing we share is one last name.
That's a dirty egg.
Talk normally.
I can't talk.
Talk normally.
What?
You're doing that thing where you go all slouchy, you just slump in on yourself when you're not into something 100%.
That's
spine depression. Straight.
It's depression. I hope you feel what I felt when you shattered my soul. Cause you were cruel and I'm a fool. So please let me go.
Tell Jesus that the bitch is back.
I was in a 212 on the uptown. Hey, nigga, you know what's up or don't you? Worker who made ya, I'm a rude bitch.
Looking at me now, I can see my past. Damn, I look just like my fucking dad.
Whiskey, I just wanted to thank you for being such a great ally.
Ally?
To the LGBTQ plus community. Thank you so much for all your efforts and for constantly learning and working on yourself.
I know a lot of you probably hate me right now, and I get it. If I could be a different person, I promise you, I would.
What I got to know. Are we still friends?
Why are both of you following me around? Why are you shopping where I shop?
I want 100 of your time, your mind.
Look, dude, I don't mean to be homophobic, but I'm just saying, the LGBTQ plus community, kinda gay.
Jason, you are dating a man.
I'm just saying, bro!
Nick, you're gay.
Huh?
You're gay. Be gay, be gay, be gay.
Be gay?
I just had to make sure these animals flush. Oh. Not you, you fastidious queen.
Oh, you must be Nick.
Well, friends call me Gay Nick.
I can fit through there.
Hmm?
You wanna know why?
Why?
Because I'm little. Give me that shoelace.
I'm necromancing, everyone's dancing. No one can stop me, I dare you to try. The dead are infused with sensational groove, and they're coming for you now, there's nowhere to hide.
Why are you so small?
Why are you so small?
Why are you so tiny?
Why are you so little?
Hey, little guy.
You know...
This is how people live when they're, like, really depressed.
So maybe I'm really depressed.
Happy Halloween. It's not Halloween.
Shut the fuck up.
Dude, go trip over a knife.
My boy, my boy, my boy. Don't love me like you promised.
Sometimes I see her on the sidewalk, biking on the wet chalk, spelling out their names. And I feel insane, cause I know it's just a game that I'm playing in my brain. I don't see her, but I see her.
Fuck you, Summer, and fuck the government, and fuck me for letting my guard down, which I will never do again.
Jeez, Rick, you can't say F you to your granddaughter.
I just did, Morty. Here's dessert. Fuck you.
This is why you don't have an arch nemesis, Terry, because you focus on the wrong details.
Maybe I don't have an arch nemesis because I solve all my crimes.
That's a pretty f***ed up thing.
Oh my god, I didn't even mean to do that.
Oh, it's fine, don't worry about it.
No, it's not fine! What the fuck?
I don't trust Red Wing.
Hold on a minute.
You don't have to trust Red Wing. But I'm gonna go see if he's right. I have a feeling they might be a part of the big three.
What big three?
The big three.
What big three?
Androids, aliens, and wizards.
That's not a thing.
That's definitely a thing.
No, it's not.
Every time we fight one of the three.
So who are you fighting now, Gandalf?
How do you know about Gandalf?
I read The Hobbit in 1937 when it first came out.
So you see my point?
No, I don't. There are no wizards.
Dr. Strange.
Is a sorcerer.
A sorcerer is a wizard without a hat. Think about it, right? I'm right, I just came up with that, it's crazy. But look, that's not the point. These guys aren't magical, all right? They use brute force, just like you. The incredibly annoying guy in front of me with the staring problem.
I'm coming with you.
No, you're not.
Is this game popular with autistic people?
Why would you say something like that?
Because I'm starting to love it.